Welcome to Green Bay Southwest High School's commencement ceremony. Everyone who is able, please rise for the singing of our national anthem by Melanie Alfaro and Desan Wilson. Today we are joined by the members of the Green Bay Police Honor Guard who will present our nation's colors. Please remain standing until the Honor Guard has retired the colors and has exited the Resch Center Arena floor.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet land of the free and the home of the
Thank you. You may now be seated. Hello, my name is Kendall Troop, and I will be your mistress of ceremonies for today's event. I want to welcome 2021 graduates, family, and friends who are here to celebrate with us tonight. We are all so grateful for the opportunity to be here in person. I've thought a lot about this speech and all the differing directions that I could take. There's the obvious direction and talking about what a decade this past year has felt like. Well, how we have persevered against all odds and we're here today. Or I could talk about all of the memories and events we were robbed of, all the frustration and hardships that this year has provided for many of us. But I don't want to dwell on the past. We are here in person, and that itself is a miracle. So instead, I want to thank you, seniors. It's crazy to think that we don't have a next year, that this was it. Our 4 years is done. Even with a third of them spent behind a computer or in quarantine, I want to thank you for making our 2.5 years of the high school experience worth it. Thank you for going to homecoming or the attempt of a dance we threw sophomore year. Thank you for going to the football games and watching the musicals. Thank you for playing sports, singing in choir, or being a part of clubs. And of course, thank you for making it to the end, even with the worst cases of senior slide to date. And finally, thank you for making memories worth cherishing when we're all old and gray. I think we can all agree that when you look around at the students, at least one of them has changed your high school years for the better. We have so much ahead of us. The world of responsibility and independence is at our fingertips. We may not feel as prepared as others have, but I believe that we write our own paths, and we have the ability to decide that our endeavors will succeed. Your future has just been dropped in the palm of your hand, so it's time to figure out the next steps. Even though growing up is scary, we have to. We are moving on to the next chapter and starting a new beginning. My mother has always told me that you will never be younger than you are today. And she's right. From here on out, we have to make the most of every memory and take every opportunity that we are given, because you never know when a pandemic is going to hit and turn your world upside down. Thank you. Our next speaker will be Elizabeth Cantwell, daughter of Paul and Cindy Cantwell, and my right-hand man as our student body vice president. She will be attending UW-Madison next fall and pursuing music education.
To my fellow 2021 graduates, it is a pleasure to be speaking in front of you today. We've had the honor of experiencing Southwest High School these last 4 years, and I can't believe that it is coming to an end. First, let's acknowledge the elephant in the room. This school year has been tough. From starting the school year virtually, to not getting homecoming, junior prom, senior prank, cookie Wednesdays, and many other pivotal high school experiences, this class has been through it all. But I'm so proud to be standing here today in front of so many people that have made it through these tough times. We as a class have managed to successfully focus on the joys in life, even in the middle of a pandemic. So sure, our grandparents can brag about walking 5 miles in a snowstorm to school, but when we are old and retired, we can brag about being able to walk up the school stairs with a mask on and without dry heaving, or being able to confidently say a singular sentence on a Zoom call. I still remember walking the halls during freshman year and thinking that the seniors at the time looked so old and grown up and that they had their lives all figured out. But looking back, my judgment couldn't have been more wrong, because I think we can all agree that as a senior class, we most definitely do not have it all figured out. We are still trying to find this balance and purpose that society expects us to know when we graduate. This balance of getting the most out of our teenage years, but also preparing for the real world, and this purpose in life of finding something and someone we love and being content with it for the rest of our adult lives. It's hard being a teenager, no doubt about it. We have already been through a pandemic, the challenges of virtual learning, the trig unit in algebra, the mustache fashion trend thing that went on in like 2010, and the Tide Pod challenge. So I'm almost positive we can survive this next chapter in our lives. Speaking of the next chapter, I am so excited to see what the class of 2021 in front of me will accomplish in the future. Hopefully being future healthcare workers, soldiers, musicians, teachers, tradespeople, athletes, and everything in between, each of us will better our communities and change the people around us for the better. It amazes me that I could someday see the same kids I went to elementary school with be successful adults looking fancy in suits, even though I knew them when they wore light-up Skechers and thought kickball was the most important thing in life. We have seen classmates and friends come and go, but here we are now, celebrating the final moments of our high school journey together. It has truly been a privilege to grow with so many of you, and it will be an even bigger privilege to see the incredible things each of you go on to do. So today, at the Southwest Class of 2021 graduation ceremony, I leave you with this quote from author Louisa May Alcott. "I am not afraid of storms, for I am learning how to sail my ship." Right now, each of us are all learning how to sail our ships in life. And I believe that one day, we're all going to become amazing captains. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2021.
Next, I would like to welcome the Southwest Principal, Broadbohm.
Thank you, Kendall, Elizabeth. Those are great speeches. Appreciate that. Good evening, everybody, and what a great evening it is for sure. Welcome to Southwest High School's 56th graduating class. We have two members with us tonight that were from the first Southwest High School graduating class, the Southwest site, the one that you walked the halls. We have Mrs. Welch with us. She's one of our board members. And up there in the control booth, the class of 1973 is Greg Binns. Thank you, Greg. And congratulations to the class of 2021. This is an incredible day for you, for our school, and for our district. I'd like to again just introduce and welcome just a few people that are here with us tonight. I've already mentioned we have our school board member Nancy Welch with us. We have Superintendent Steve Murley with us on stage. I don't know if Vicki Beyer, our deputy superintendent, if she is here, and Judy Wiegen, our executive director of secondary schools. And of course, our immensely talented Southwest staff, they are all over. I want to thank them for everything that they have done. And seniors, let's take a moment to thank all the beautiful people in the Resch Center today, the people who have provided love, encouragement, and support during your high school journey. Graduates, please join me in giving a big round of applause to all the friends, family, and school staff who are gathered here to celebrate your special day. This is indeed a very special day for everybody in the arena here today. Before I move on, I missed a couple people behind me, Mr. Van Lannen, Mr. Lipsch, and Ms. Hogan. Members of the Southwest administrative team that make the work seem easy and fun all at the same time. I'd also like to give a shout out to everybody that's connected to the Resch Center who have made this day possible for us in this arena. They have been gracious and incredibly helpful every step of the way. So seniors, now it's your turn. I get the opportunity to share a few final thoughts. Green Bay Southwest High School, people of courageous determination and energy. This bold statement is displayed proudly above the main office doors with the hope that during your last 4 years, or two and a half as we've heard, it has served as a reminder of two important elements that are needed to lead you in the right direction of success and ultimately be at your best. On behalf of Southwest High School, I am proud to proclaim that these seniors have achieved tremendous levels of success as defined by and through their actions. During their time at Southwest, our students and staff have worked in unison to create opportunities to learn, grow, and succeed through our experiences as individuals, as groups, in our teams, and in our performance opportunities. I want to highlight just something that speaks to the amazing talent that's in front of us. This year's class of 2021 has earned roughly $1 million in scholarships this year. Since 2011 at Southwest High School, we've had nearly 4,000 graduates, and I'm happy to say that that collection of 4,000 graduates, they have earned $17 million in scholarships. That's a pretty amazing feat. This is, along with those other graduates, this class, it's an amazing feat, and it helps to define how great this class is. We're all very proud of you. And seniors, you should be very proud of your accomplishments as well. And of course, you're not done yet. Class of 2021, your high school chapter within your life story has now been written, and it may be used as a springboard to the next chapters in your life. It is my hope that your next chapter will have roots anchored in meaningful and significant lessons learned during high school, and that these will lead to new and meaningful experiences that will become an incredible highlight reel that showcases your exciting achievements and successes. The next chapter also lends itself as a new time to become even more mindful and focused, more caring and aware of your world, and more grateful and full of grace, and that you will reveal more and more of your genius and your splendor. We all hope your next chapter is full of story after story of great happiness, joy, fulfillment, and success. However, there will be those times that create great challenge and hardship and exceptional difficulties. During these times, keep in mind the Trojan spirit of courageous determination and energy. You may find that you begin to question yourself, even who you are, or your ability to stay strong, asking questions such as, can I do this? Can I really do this? You may feel empty, insignificant, overwhelmed, and full of doubt. Sometimes the best we can do during these times is just to exist and survive in the moment. Others will try to offer advice that they feel is right. They may ask you to just bury those thoughts or those emotions. But these emotions and feelings are difficult moments, and they are part of us, a part of being human, a part of being alive. We need to remain strong during those times. These challenges, these challenging moments present opportunities for growth and help us to gain strength, determination, help us to gain energy, resilience, and so much more, all to improve our lives. However, to do this well, you must exist, in order to do this well, you must exist beyond the moment. Be mindful of your thoughts and take a step back and just realize you don't need to buy into every single idea and thought that doesn't contribute to greatness, especially when you're listening and becoming overwhelming and even limiting yourself. Rather, you and your potential are limitless and full of greatness, and your strength and courage runs deep. Overcome difficult times by learning to push through moments. Refocus and channel the energy to sometimes become even more positive and significant. Gain support and confidence by leaning on those that you know you can trust, that care for you and love you. These are the experiences that will undoubtedly contribute to you while revealing and redefining what greatness and success is going to look like you for you now and in the future. Seniors, as Trojans and people of courageous determination and energy, please pursue what the late Stephen Covey identified as everyday greatness, a greatness that tends to be more quiet by nature, one that generally escapes the headlines, yet it is the greatness that, in my opinion, is the most deserving of a higher honor, even more respect. Everyday greatness has to do with character and contribution. Everyday greatness is a way of living, and it's not a one-time event. It says more about who a person is than what a person has, and is portrayed more by the goodness that radiates from a face than the title on a business card. It speaks more about people's motives than their talents, more about small and simple deeds than about extravagant accomplishments. And everyday greatness is humble. Soon each of you will go your separate way with the opportunity to live a life of greatness and success at home, at work, in college, in the community, in your families. No matter what your circumstance may be, such a decision can be made by each of you. You have the power to make a new tomorrow and to decide to live a life of greatness. Pursuing everyday greatness is enhanced when you find your passion, that which serves as a source of inspiration, renewal, and energy. And as I bring this to a close, I want to share a brief excerpt that holds special meaning for me, and I hope it will spark something within you. It is called Love the Game. When you hear the words love the game, please think of your talents, what you are passionate about, and what serves as a source of strong personal motivation. You can create your own meaning. For example, for me, I could substitute family for the love of the game. I could substitute being a principal at Southwest High School for love the game. Love the game for the pure joy of accomplishment. Love the game for everything it can teach you about yourself. Love the game for the feeling of belonging to a group endeavoring to do its best. Love the game for being involved in a team whose members can't wait to see you do your best. Love the game for the challenge of working harder than you ever have at something, and then harder than that. Love the game because it takes all team members to give it life. Love the game because at its best, the game tradition will include your contributions. Love the game because you belong to a long line of people who have loved it. It is now your legacy. Love the game so much that you will pass on your love of the game to another person who has seen your dedication, your work, your challenges, your triumphs, and then that person will, because of you, love the game. Seniors, you are what is right in this world. Each of you has inspired us, touched our hearts, and given us tremendous hope of a brighter tomorrow. We are people, we are better people because you have come into our lives. In closing, each of you will go a different direction. I hope you will keep in your heart and carry with you during your life's journey the Green Bay Southwest High School vision. Together we will pursue learning, build confidence, demonstrate pride, create opportunities, encourage acceptance, and inspire greatness. Keeping these as priorities in your life will help you to recognize abundance, see possibilities, stretch you to the edge so that you can be at your best for the world. And today, arguably more than any other time in our history, the world needs the Southwest High School seniors, people of courageous determination and energy to emerge strong, be difference makers, and leave a legacy of everyday greatness. Let's fill the history books with your amazing stories of triumph, will, achievements, overcoming obstacles, love, and compassion. And on behalf of the entire Southwest High School staff, I would like to congratulate all of you and wish you a lifetime of happiness. Superintendent Steve Murley, as principal of Green Bay Southwest High School, I am very pleased and exceptionally proud to present to you Southwest High School's class of 2021. They are our hope of yesterday, our joy of today, and our guarantee of a better tomorrow.
As superintendent of schools, few things are as rewarding as participating in your high school graduation ceremony. As you prepare to cross the stage and move forward with your lives, I'd like to share with you an excerpt from a speech by the 26th President of the United States, Theodore Roosevelt, entitled Citizenship in a Republic. He delivered this speech over 100 years ago at the Sorbonne in Paris, France, on April 23, 1910. It is not the critic who counts, not the person who points out how the strong person stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the person who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who actually does strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms and the great devotions, who spends themselves in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if they fail, at least fail while daring greatly, so that their place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. Many of you have been with us for 13 years. Some of you have joined us along the way. It is clear that you have all worked hard to reach this goal. Members of your class have compiled an impressive list of accomplishments, and based on your triumphant journey through the district, we will continue to expect great things from the class of 2021 in the years to come. While this is certainly not the school year or the end of your school career that we expected, this is your day, and many of you will remember and treasure the way you feel for years to come, carrying that feeling of success with you wherever you go. Before you leave high school behind, though, take a moment to think about the friends you have made, the teachers, administrators, and school staff who helped you reach this goal, and most importantly, your parents and family who have stood beside you through every triumph and defeat. Remember to say thank you to all of them for helping you reach this milestone. As you close the door on your high school career, remember to hold on to the lessons and the hopes and dreams you have shared at Southwest High School. Years from now, you will be amazed just how much these days, these people, and this community have meant to you. Wherever life takes you, make sure that you remember the past and the promise that lies within each of you today. Graduates, as Roosevelt said, remember to strive valiantly and dare greatly as you seek victory in the arena, and always remember your Trojan roots. Rodney Bohm, principal of Southwest High School, has indicated that the class of 2021 has met the graduation requirements of the state of Wisconsin and the Green Bay Area Public School District. On behalf of the Board of Education, it gives me great pleasure to accept the class of 2021. Congratulations.
All right, we are going to prepare to distribute the diplomas.
Elizabeth Cantwell. Kendall Troop. Rhoda Abib. Tricity Ackley. Caleb Aguirre. Garrett Aguirre. Melanie Afaro. Kausar Ali. Brett Ament. Trinity Andre. Cynthia Aron Rivera. Aiden Bartelt. Hunter Bauer. Lily Bernard. Madeline Biro. Jeffrey Bizzo. Argina Black Owl. Anaya Blewett. Griffin Bormans. Elvin Botorf. Michael Brown. Abigail Briegel. Caden Brulee. Caleb Brunette. Mary Bahacek. Alex Caldwell. Maria Calhoun. Veronica Caru. Dalton Chernetsky. Aaron Clements. Shamiko Coburn. Reese Collard. Hudson Cornelius. Emily Cornett. Nico Corpus. Ariana Cottrell. Atticus Cruz. Bryn Kumacek. Naomi Curiel. Paige Dahl. Jacob DeMoulin. Annabelle Dennis. Rafael Diaz Molina. Aiden Diederich. Genesis Dowd. Alina Doyen. Alexis Doyle. McKenna Duquesne. Montana Farmer. Kaylee Farron. Jada Foster. Cara Francis. Braden Freeberg. Caitlin Generose. Cameron George. Allison Gillis. Camille Gonzalez. Trevor Gracielny. Marie Green. Brooklyn Gamini. Bailey Hamilton Zimdars. Vernicia Hampton. Sierra Helgeson. Ava Helstad. Casey Hendricks. Savannah Hendricks. Alyssa Henriksen. Jacob Herlash. Lasaya Hill. Ethan Hipke. Cody Holm.
Cooper Huntington. Connor Jasmer. Bailey Jokey. Maya Johannik. Connor Johnson. Dakota Jordan. Kyle Connick. Emma Kanyu. Jessica Clowitter. Emma Klug. Reese Knoll. Kaylee Kornowski. Alexander Kowalczyk. Darren Kramer. Austin Kukta. Eliza LaCourcier. Gina Lai. Paige Lawrence. Yeah. Owen Lemons. Lauren Lapine. Nathan Lesperance. Lucy Lindstrom. Wendy Lopez Mejia. Aviana Lohr. Keith Lohr. Olivia Marchant. Tyler McClure. Anastasia McDermott. Marco McDermott Mercado. Madison McFerrin. Annika McNaughton. Demetrius Maletti. Andrew Minton. Alyssa Napier. Samuel Noss. Hunter Now. Lauren Nelson. Sean Nelson. Gabrielle Norman. Liam O'Leary. Jamie Ann Olson. Leticia Ortiz. Maxwell Peaches. Jaziel Perez Carrasquillo. Jasmine Peters. Samuel Peterson. Hallie Pokala. Isaiah Polenko. Justin Poley. Josephine Polson. Yosef Ponce. Peyton Reisner. Elizabeth Rocher. Emily Raymaker. Kyle Reynolds. Brooke Robb. Olivia Robertson. Lydia Rodriguez Quinozne. Joseph Roscoe. Mitchell Rupnow. Isaiah Rush. Ethan Schakowsky. Lindsay Shermans. Amanda Selden. Kaylin Serrano. Elena Siebers. Aiden Seetong.
Gabrielle Sudinsky. Grant Skinnerdor. Alyssa Sparacio. Javen Stevens. Owen Stieber. Khalid Sufai. Caden Summers. Dakota Supa. Giovanni Szymanski. Trinity Thino. Jaden Thomas. Tanissa Thomas. Kira Thompson. Samantha Tolke. Alexander Tolme. Sherilyn Tolme. Gabriella Trujillo. Zachary Valley. Olivia Van Elzen. Abigail Vanderwedge. Colton Van Geem. Moses Van Horn. Vincent McGem. Jacob Van Weevenoven. Lynette Valise. Carson Vinger. Shaw Voigt. Sarah Walters. Hannah Warner. Peyton Weirs. Sadie Williman. Desan Wilson. Janaya Woods. Brenna Wipashinsky. Holly Zhang. Zoa Zhang. Jetrin Yang. Tishan Yang. Jingzi Yang. Ariana Zaragoza. Kelly Zhang. Neiman Abdi Mohammed. Okay.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You've heard it a few times. This is a proud day for the Green Bay Area Public Schools and, of course, for Green Bay Southwest High School and our community. Okay, seniors, it's time to make it official. Seniors and faculty, please rise. Seniors, on a count of three, move your tassels from the right to the left. One, two, three.
Oh,
Nice.
I didn't signal to you guys.
Oh,
sorry.
We'll end it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Take it out with a bang.
Oh my goodness.
This way, it's a shortcut.
Oh, it's a shortcut. Yeah, I gotta grab a hand.
Yeah, I gotta get my card. I'll see you guys.
Thank you. Thanks for